First of all, you need to cook the potato. I don't peel it. I don't do anything like that. I just wash it off and I don't even scrub them. I just get the sand or dirt that's on there off and then I throw them in the pan. These are going to be in boiling water, so you don't have to scrub them with special vegetable stuff or anything like that. And I cook them because they'll turn black if you try to do this raw. So you have to cook these first. Now, what I do is you can't cook them till they're totally mushy. You don't want to overcook them, but you've got to make sure you get them cooked in the center. Once you do it a couple of times, you'll get the feel of it and understand. And I'm going to just jab my fingers, aren't I? But I just take a knife or a skewer of some bamboo skewer of some sort, and I just poke it in. And if it goes slides in really easy, it's ready. Just cook them for about 10 minutes normally. Like Colorado's a little bit more high altitude, so it's going to be a little bit different. And so you just, this one you could see, it just slides right in. See, it's no, I didn't have to work at that.
No resistance.
And so I cook them like that. And then what I do is after you got to let them cool. And then I use all three. I use my fingers. These skins are much thinner, so they're not peeling quite as easy with my fingers, but you can see I can still do it. But I can do it with a peeler. You can do it with a knife. Peel them like this. Whatever you feel most comfortable doing, I do all three of them. It just doesn't matter. And you just peel them like this and get those peels off. Now, after I get them all peeled, then I take and just grate them. Just use grater and grate them.
And yeah, you can do this in the food processor if you want.
Oh yeah, anything, any way to get them grate. Now, you do grate it. You don't want to use anything that would mush them though. You don't want to get them too mushy. You want these, see how these are kind of loose. And then once I get them grated, I put them on the dehydrator tray. And I spread them out kind of thin. You don't have to just worry over this too much. You see how I'm just kind of spreading them out a little bit? And I'll just fill this whole tray up really, really thin and then stick them in the dehydrator. You can also, if you don't want to do hash browns, you can slice them and do, I try to get them as thin as I can, about an eighth to a quarter of an inch. Like I say, don't worry about it too much. That's usually, I don't know if they can see the thickness there. And that's about the average thickness. Now, of course, these will probably take a little bit longer to dehydrate. But if I put double, like the hash browns and this on the same tray, and these get done first, I just take those off, and then I let those finish doing a little bit more. And these will probably take, a lot of this stuff can take about 10 hours. What happens is sometimes these will do more, the hash browns will maybe cook faster than the sliced ones.
Not cook, dehydrate.
Oh, I know, I can't get dehydrated. It is dry out faster. And so if that happens, just pull the hash browns off and let the other ones finish dehydrating. And another thing is they'll take about 10 hours. Most of this stuff will take, 10 to 12 hours, something like that. I leave them for 24 hours just because I do the stuff up in the morning. At 10 o'clock at night, they're probably ready, but I don't want to mess at 10 o'clock at night, putting them in the jars or the bags and doing all that. So I just leave them in the dehydrator, maybe turn them down a little bit lower if you want, and just leave them overnight, and then the next morning I bag them up. That's why I say about 24 hours, because, it's easier.
And there are YouTubers that we've seen that put oil and stuff on their things. Don't put oil on your stuff. I don't know where that came from, but that's not a good idea. It will go rancid and spoil your food.
It like she said, it goes rancid and it won't last as long in your pantry then. The less you have like that on there, add those types of things afterwards and that.
Yep. All right, we'll come back when they're dry. Okay, guys, we are back 24 hours later. Here is our dehydrated potatoes and hash browns. You can see how they turned out pretty good there. To rehydrate them, all you do,
I was going to show them on this. make sure you cook the potatoes through really well, because sometimes they'll get a black spot type thing in the center, and that means you haven't cooked them all the way through. Keep the ones that aren't black and just throw those at, you know, you can, or you can break it off if you want.
Well, it doesn't hurt to eat the black.
No,
does it?
Well, it can get moldy, I think, and not do something doesn't do right on it. Okay. So you really probably shouldn't keep the black. But if you cook them all, make sure you cook them all the way through. But I wanted to show you an example of, usually they're even more black than this. This is only like a light brown.
All right, then to store them, you can either put them in a glass jar, or you can put them in baggies.
Or
if you want,
plastic containers.
Yeah, if you want to use the oxygen packets, you can put the oxygen packets
vacuum
in there.
Vacuum seal them.
That just keeps them fresher longer, but you don't have to. But yeah, you can vacuum seal them whatever you want.
Mm-hmm.
Then to rehydrate them, just pour boiling water over the top. And let it sit for about, 10 to 20 minutes. Just kind of depends on how thin you grate it up.
And what vegetable you're doing, too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then your potatoes are ready to go. Just fry your hash browns up like normal and use your other potatoes like you normally would. Put your potatoes straight in the soup or stew if you are using them for soup or stew. That's a great way
to just throw
them straight in there.
They need like 30 minutes to an hour in a soup or stew to rehydrate. You don't have to rehydrate them in the boiling water first. You just throw them in there. Now, don't just throw this juice away that you're rehydrating them in, because you may have some juice left over and have to drain them. Use that juice, save it, and use it in vegetable soup. You can freeze it, you know, to use, pull out for vegetable soup or something like that, or in a vegetable casserole. That's good juice. It has some of the, you know, flavor and stuff from there.
Yeah.
So
that is how you dehydrate potatoes. Please visit us at livingonadime.com. Check out our other videos on dehydrating. Please like, subscribe, share, hit that notification bell, and we will see you guys next time.
Bye-bye.